But George, it's a fair point, isn't it? Thatcher, you wouldn't say Thatcher was, you know, a compromising figure.
No, I agree with Deborah.
She compromised to the extent of remaining within one of the main political parties, whereas your policy has been to stick to views that are purely your own, that a broader political consensus won't get behind.
She didn't sit there and say, what do the opinion polls say? I'll do what the opinion polls say. She said, I believe in this, and I'll try and persuade the people to support this. And that's
what
the country... This is not a game. Our country is going down the drain.
All right, George.
We're in ruins.
George, how long did it take for her to work out trade union reform? Did she come in and say, I'm going to sort those out? It took her nine years. 9 years
Nicholas
she spent
Ridley
on that particular problem.
Throughout the
she was very, very cautious.
To smash the unions. They were waiting for their moment, like a serial killer, to smash organised labour in this country.
9 years on trade union reform.
I absolutely knew that tonight would end with everyone agreeing that Thatcher's great, but just for their own different reasons. We haven't quite solved it there, but maybe the future is an increased emulsification into lots of different parties, and in which case the House of Commons will become tremendously confusing. Anyway, some adverts to calm down over.
This week saw one of the biggest celebrity controversies of the decade splashed across the front pages. No, not him. Or him. I'm talking about Dame Helen Mirren's fabulously foul-mouthed rant. As Charlie said earlier, Dame Helen screamed, "Shut the fuck up! People have paid fucking £100 for their theatre tickets! National fucking treasure." she's got a point, though, hasn't she? I mean, you know, you're an actor. You know what she was driving at.
The tickets are too expensive, she's right. I have to say, I do admire her for the phrase, fucking £100.
Yeah.
Not £100 fucking pounds, a fucking £100. I think it's a new way of doing it, fucking £100. It's like an activity. What are you doing? I'm fucking £100.
It's like a task. It's like a task on The Apprentice.
It's like, yes, a sort of mini Brewster's Millions. Who can fuck £100 quickest?
Coming into money. Terrible thing.
Do you think Prince Philip fancies Helen Mirren? I bet in Buckingham Palace of an evening around this time you'll just hear, "I'll be up in a minute, Liz." Just watching the end of this Prime Suspect.
You cannot talk about that. That's definitely treason.
Okay. Well, it's not the first time Helen Mirren has turned the air blue. Here she is on BBC Breakfast talking about the late great actor Sir John Gielgud. Now remember, this was 9 o'clock in the morning.
He always took kind of edgy choices.
Yes, and he swore a lot, as I remember.
And there was in that sort of wonderful voice he had.
Exactly. Yeah. No, that was
you
the
little
comedy.
Shit.
He said.
Sorry. Now, to be fair, Sian's fault, and she knows it.
Well, when Helen Mirren says shit, it stays said. You can hear right
the back
the
of the room.
Shit.
Shitting
it's
towards
like
the back of the room.
She's done the shit with him.
Okay, that would be amazing acting.
Yeah, Daniel Day-Lewis can do that.
Let's move
on. He's a real pro.
Let's move on to the real queen. It's been reported today that she's planning to hand over more of her duties to Prince Charles. The palace have denied the rumours. But, Jimmy, do you think it's time that Liz stepped aside and let Charles have a bit of a crack?
So the queen's stepping aside and she's giving the job to Prince Charles. It's nepotism, isn't it? It stinks of nepotism. I'm calling it what it is. I don't think he's gone for a, you know, it's not like Alan Sugar's gone through a process and he's got the job.
Do you think that would help if that, I mean...
No, that definitely wouldn't help.
Do you think you could do a royal version of The Apprentice, the Queen sitting there with all of her children? Horrible to Edward.
Kind of what they did in the old days. I mean, this has happened before, right? They've been, you know, like the Prince Regent was in lieu of...
Yeah, the Prince Regent. He was a Prince Regent. He's one. and there isn't another one. Okay. And he was an asshole. He became king later. He was a very, very bad king. And he was very drunk a lot of the time. And he came to the point where he thought he'd been at the Battle of Waterloo. And people, the Duke of Wellington, he'd be at dinner with the Duke of Wellington talking about being at the Battle of Waterloo, and the Duke of Wellington had to go along with it and sort of go, oh, yes, Your Majesty, you were very brave. Well done for coming on, and wasn't able to say in those days, you cowardly fat little shit. You weren't there, and if you had been there, you'd have run away and wet yourself.
Why weren't you my history teacher? And genuinely, that's fascinating, and that never came up.
This is the least topical material.
Next week, we'll stick it to Edward III.
Would watch. OK, into the future now, actually. William and Kate, the papers recently brought us a shocking new image of the Duke and Duchess reimagined as 80-year-olds. Here they are. Jimmy, they still make such a handsome couple.
Hang on a second. He's got more hair there than he has now. That can't be right, can it?
Wow. That's why are we that impatient to see what they'll look like when they're old?
What will they look like when they're dead? What will they look like when they're rotted? What will they look like when they're gone?
The only question you haven't asked, David, is what will their child look like?
When he's dead? No. That's not...
That's
I'm such a keen royalist. I just want to see pictures of them all dead. I want it on a tea towel. I've got the Romanovs.
The same artist also imagined what William and Kate's child would grow up to look like, be it a boy or girl. Take this, ultrasounds. Check this out. How do you feel to meet your future monarch, gentlemen?
They do just look like two fucks off The Apprentice.
What if that's a picture of just one human being? And that the new royal will be a double-headed royal. And one head is female and one head is male, and it can mate with itself.
I think it might be just sort of, he's just put on a wig and just gone, I actually feel more comfortable on the left. I feel more myself.
Well, now, as William approaches fatherhood, this recent footage of the prince in Glasgow shows that he may need some help when it comes to dealing with children.
Is that for Kate? Yeah, you want to give it to her. You look very pretty. You want a kiss, do you? Oh, no! There you go. Next time, Shona, next time.
I think at the last minute there, that kid's gone. He's not been CRB checked. I'll just leave it. There's been a lot of stuff in the papers recently. I'm just going to leave it.
The most disturbing thing about that, there was someone filming it with an iPad. They had it in the correct aspect ratio, but... When Prince William's there, don't hold an opaque rectangle in front of your face. This is what makes me more angry than anything.
OK. That's enough royal news for now. So, next up, last week's local election results were seen as a game-changer here in the UK, but how were they seen by the rest of the world? Well, we've got our hands on American news network KCZNC's coverage. They sent their star reporter, Pat Puddison, to Britain to cover the elections. And here's his special report, Democracy in Action.
You're watching KZZNC Channel 9 News. This is Democracy in Action. This week, the UK local elections with award-winning anchor Pat Puddison.
I'm Pat Puddison, and this is KCZNC News. Behind you, a polling station. Are you voting today?
I didn't realize it was voting day. Who am I voting for?
God damn it, man.
Sir, why is today the most important day of your life?
But it's not the most important day of my life.
And can you just agree and say it is? London, England. God damn fucking get it. If you had a bigger penis, you wouldn't be driving around on that fucking thing. How did you lose your legs?
I haven't lost my legs. Had a hip operation some years ago that was all right, and then my left.
My mother-in-law was having a hip operation. No one gives a shit. Okay, so why don't you just go with the whole war hero thing and make you look better? It's going out in America anyway. No one gives a fuck. Okay?
And who have you voted for today, madam? May I ask?
No, this is secret.
Yeah, but you can tell me, though. You can tell me anyway. BNP.
We are here with a voter of the BNP. Why did you vote BNP? A war hero, a loving husband, and now...
No, I never married.
Get out of the way, my goddamn shot, man.
Fuck off.
Yeah, fuck you.
This is Pat Puddison in some shithole in Great Britain. Fucking hate it.
Welcome back. We've just got time to look at one or two more stories that caught our eye this week. First up, the extraordinary news that boffins have invented a 3D printable gun capable of firing bullets. It's nicknamed the Liberator. Let's have a look at some of the terrifying but oddly compelling promotional video. Yeah, I mean, what is wrong with humans?
I like the idea that, because it's a 3D, so you have to print a gun. Mm. So, like, in the future, there'll be a gun battle, like OK Corral-style gun battle, where two guys just have to reach for Control P. And then wait.
If it's like, I mean, if I know printers, the gun is going to be really cheap, but the cartridges are going to cost a fortune. You know what I'd do? If I had a 3D printer, if I had a 3D printer, I would fuck with it by getting it to print sheets of paper.
Mm. But it's not just printable guns that are available. There's also printable clothes, printable beef, and perhaps most worryingly of all, there's this charming 3D printable Justin Bieber sex aid, which we can have a look at here. Definitely exists. There it is.
He looks so miserable.
Yeah, well, he's about to be shoved up somewhere, isn't he?
I can think of worse things. I think my sex doll from earlier was better.
Which the apprentice one of the guy. Apprentice? Yeah. Can we get him back?
I don't think we can.
We'll have a look at this. We did actually get
hold... Oh, there he is.
There he is. We did actually get hold of a 3D printer ourselves, and Jimmy, do you recognise this handsome fellow?
You 3D printed
Check him
my...
out. I did. Look,
it's
camera
kind
two.
Kind of a likeness, isn't it?
That is excellent.
That is a funny story. That is actually how they made me. That's how they do it, yeah.
That is just an amazing thing, isn't it? And it says Jimmy inside your neck, just like in real life. Just like
3D printers, right? They can make anything sort of be, but what's the toner? I mean, what? Because you said there's printable beef. So presumably printable beef, the toner has to be
Yes, it's
beef.
A kind of weird protein that then...
And could you make the gun out of beef? Could you make a Jimmy out of beef? Or do you have to choose...
Like
I've got no plastic toner left. I've only got beef and chocolate. And I have to make the gun out of a mixture of beef and chocolate. And I might backfire.
This sounds like an amazing
It
future.
Is horrifying. Look, let's have a quick look at tomorrow's headlines. Jimmy, I've got the mail here. £90 fine if you're texting at the wheel. I read about that on my BlackBerry on the way over. Terrible.
I don't understand this headline. It's a great cut. It's like, looks brilliant, but it's hairdryer. I don't really get the reference. Did he used to blow people in the dressing room or...?
Oh, Jimmy, no.
If you don't know the context that for that, which I don't, that looks like a remarkable work of art.
It's
an amazing surreal statement by the Sun. I love that.
It's quite beautiful. Mm.
And I like the fact that he's the most successful football manager in British footballing history. I think that goes somewhere to explaining why he always looks so cheerful. You can see him there shouting like a maniac at all times. He just never seems happy, and he's the most successful guy ever. I'm not sure whether football's working for people.
I've got the Manchester Evening News, which has a depressing headline for any elderly readers when that's coming through your door. It just says, your time has come.
OK. Well, guys, I'm afraid that's all we've got time for.
We don't get to do the Star. Don't buy the Star, it's shit.
I think that's it for this week, then. Thank you very much for watching. We'll see you next week. Good night.